Hey guys, Welsknight here, bringing you the brand new episode in my Lord of the Rings Online Beorning Let's Play. And in this episode, we are going to be working on the Farmers Market quests that you find in Oatbarton, which is in Evendim. And we're pretty much exactly where we left off. We're just clearing out the locusts from Nibs Chubb's field. Just kind of getting rid of some of these guys so that we can help him out. Looks like we need two more swarming locusts. And I suppose I could probably go into bear form. I keep forgetting that I have a bear form because I am indeed a terrible Beorning. I've just kind of come to accept that. I need to start breaking some of these habits, but it's easier said than done. Easier said than done. Okay, so there we go. Find anything amiss in his field. So we're looking for killed deer. Here's one over here. And there's that mysterious relic. So we found one deer. And this is a goofy quest because you have to find the deer and kind of run over them, but it doesn't give you any sort of a pop-up notification that you found something amiss until you've randomly walked over top of three or four deer. This is kind of a weird quest. I don't know what the deal is with it, but there's three deer, and then there's one more up here, I believe. I think there are a total of four, if I remember correctly. I've done this quest many, many times, but it has been a while. Let's see. There's a wolf. I thought it was, like, right up here somewhere is the last deer that we need. Let's take a look and see. Jump. Walk on the fence. Yeah, there it is. And now we get attacked by a wolf. So you basically have to run over those four or five deer. And then on the last one, a wolf spawns, basically. And then it gives you the quest. So it's kind of a weird quest. It's not really very well explained. The first time that I did it, I had a lot of trouble figuring out what in the world I was supposed to be doing. So, there's that one. Let's, do that. Now we gotta talk to Hal Gamgee, who is, I'm pretty sure he's actually in town. He's either in town or he's in North Cotton Farms. Either way, we gotta go this direction. So, let's head this way towards town. Yeah, I see the quest ring for Hal Gamgee. Hello, Hal Gamgee. Collect elk meat. Let's go. Yeah, actually, let's do this one. Let's get this one taken care of. Let's get all of Nibs Chubb's quests done so we can head to the farm and get to the bulk of the quests. This is the only one that happens outside of North Cotton Farms. Having difficulty talking right now. It's about 3 in the morning when I'm recording this. I've got another video rendering, and then I've got some stuff to upload, and it's been a long day, but not too bad. Overall life is good. I can't complain. Seem to have pulled something on accident. Whatever. Let's just kill some of these elk so that we can get some of that elk meat. Hopefully it will let us move right on. Nope, we gotta bring it back to him. These quests, there's so much running around. We won't be able to get all the quests done in this one episode, I'm sure. But I don't think I'm going to take another episode for these quests. I'll probably do the remainder of what we don't get done in this episode. I'll probably get the remainder of them done off camera. That's kind of what I'm thinking. And then we'll start probably dwalling next episode. That's kind of my plan. So let's sneak over here. Hello, Hal Gamgee. Is there something I can do for you? And then he sends us off to slay the wolf Bonefang, which is just a great name, I must say. Such an excellent name for a character, Bonefang. How original. That was sarcasm. By the way, if you didn't pick up that that was sarcasm, that was definitely sarcasm. Okay, moving on. Let's see here. Bonefang. Did I? Whoa. More wolves. Ah, wolves. They're all over me. Where's Bonefang? I thought Bonefang was like... Oh, it's giving me a different... Gotcha. I see what's going on. Okay, let's take care of these guys real quick. We'll just shift into bear form so we can get rid of them quickly. And... Or... There we go. Got him. Okay, so Bonefang. Let's look at our map. Bonefang is way up this direction. That's what I thought. I was going to say, I thought he was quite a ways outside of town. I was looking at the wrong quest marker. He's kind of up this way. And he's basically just a wolf. You just summon him by putting the slab of meat on a little rock. And then it comes out and attacks you. Let's see, where is the... Ah, there it is. Apparently I pulled something. But I'm not super worried. Hopefully we won't get attacked by... Ooh, I got a lot of things coming after me. They're all out to get me. There's Bonefang right there. This might get a little hairy, guys. Might get a little bit hairy. Let's hit our healing skill so we can get that heal over time on us. Bonefang just wants to sit there. So let's go deal with him. I should probably use my cleanse skill to get that poison off of me. We'll go for the bear. Bring down the defense. Hit our little swarm of bees skill that we earned fairly recently, because I kind of want to try it out and see if it's any good. And there we go, we got him. Apparently one of his minions wants to tango with us as well, though. That's all right, that's all right. We can take him. All right, there we go. So that takes care of that. Let's go ahead and head back to town and try not to pull everything along the way. So we can turn this off, and then we can finally head into North Cotton Farms and actually start getting some of these other quests finished up, which is good. All right, so let's see here. There's Hal, riding on the roofs, kind of breaks immersion if you're an RP lover. I guess we'll just grab these. It doesn't really matter. What are you... Oh, talk to Alvin Northcotton. Okay. I was going to say, what's that other quest? But I remember. Alright, so now we will head up the pathway into Northcotton Farms, which is like right up there. And we should be able to take out a lot of these quests pretty quickly. Most of them are pretty quick. They don't take very long. And they're relatively peaceful. So this is a great area for leveling if you're right around level 28-ish. Somewhere 28, 30. These quests are mostly meant for level 30 and above, but because they are not very dangerous at all, because they're all relatively peaceful and it's like, you know, go bring the sheep back to the pen, like this one. You can do them even if you're well under level. Although, honestly, you can do most of the quests in this game if you're well under level, and it's not really an issue. Okay, so we'll gather ourselves a sheep. But we have to... I think we actually have to bring the sheep back. Maybe. Maybe we can gather them all at once. Let's go find out. And we can talk with Rosa Brockhaus as well. Collect wheat. Oh, we can't gather more than one sheep at a time. Okay. Well, we'll take this guy back. This does definitely make me miss my hunter, though, with my improved movement speed. I think if I mount on my horse, the sheep will stop following me. But I'm not 100% sure. So we're just going to play it safe and bring the sheep to the pen over here. And there's one sheep. We'll grab this pitchfork as well, which is for another quest. There's a tool gathering quest that we're also working on. We will jump up on our horse so we can get some of this done a little bit faster. And there were plenty of sheep up this way, so let's just get a few more. We need like three more, I believe. Yeah, three more sheep. No problem. Piece of cake. We can do that. We got this, guys. We totally got this. All right. So we will just head back to the pen. It's just a lot of running around. But as I said, it's kind of nice to have a nice little peaceful area to quest that's relatively free of action. It's kind of a nice change of pace in a game where so many of the quests are go kill these and go kill 10 of this and 5 of this and go get rid of bandits and investigate the danger and, you know, all that kind of stuff. It's kind of nice to have a nice little peaceful, hey, let's go prepare for the farmer's market. You know, kind of mixes up the pace a little bit, and I really like that. I think that's one of the reasons that this area is one that I love so much. I love Evendim, and I really kind of like all these quests in North Cotton Farms. They really, I don't know what it is about them exactly, but I really enjoy them. I would even probably go so far as to say that Evendim is my favorite area below level 50. That's probably what I would say. Moria, of course, is awesome and epic and great. Some of the other later areas, Mirkwood, for example, is very well done, has that kind of creepy vibe to it. Gondor and Rohan are huge, but of the areas that were in the original prior to Moria expansions, let's put it that way, in the areas that came before Moria, I would say that Evendim is my favorite ever since it got a revamp anyway. Okay, so we actually can ride our sheep, and now we will talk to this guy. And now he wants us to go get chickens. And then I believe we use the chickens to get eggs or something like that. I don't remember exactly. But the chickens are over here, and I think I actually have to carry the chickens, if I remember correctly. We're gonna find out. Yep, definitely have to carry the chickens around. I seem to have a sheep following me as well. Apparently that sheep didn't get the memo that it was supposed to, stay in the pen. But, you know, these things happen. Oh, and the chickens actually go over here, I should say. I was trying to take the chickens to the sheep and cow pen, and that's just not working out. Let's jump up on our horse again. Makes travel a little bit faster. We also will have to light some of these lamp posts eventually. Do-do-do-do, chicken. So, in other channel news, I have decided to restart my single-player survival Minecraft series. If you are a fan of Minecraft, or if you're a fan of the old Minecraft 1.8 single-player survival series, definitely check out the new one. I've decided to do it in a amplified biome world, which is pretty nifty. So episode 1 of that came out yesterday. If you haven't seen it already, definitely check that out. Also, school is starting up for me here pretty shortly. Later this week is when I'm going to start having other obligations again. And I'm really, 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 really hoping that I'm not going to have to cut back the amount of content that I'm producing. At the current time, right now I'm putting out 2 videos a day, basically every day. And I'm hoping I'm not going to have to cut that back, but we'll see how my class load is. When I went to pick up my books, I had no less than 13 textbooks. 13! That's a little insane. Granted, I'm taking a Shakespeare class this semester, and of those 13, about 9 of them were Shakespeare books or Shakespeare plays. You know, I don't know why they couldn't find an anthology that had all the relevant plays in it and just make us get one textbook. But no, they wanted us to get a separate book for, you know, Macbeth and Julius Caesar and King Lear and all these other ones. It is what it is. But if the semester is as crazy as my massive quantity of textbooks is suggesting, I may have to cut back the amount of content that I'm producing. I do have some things in motion right now to make that happen if necessary. So please forgive me. I don't think I would be cutting back the amount of LOTRO content that I'm producing, though. And the reason... Oh, and that one has a... I need a bucket for this one that's, like, way over somewhere else. And the reason that I wouldn't be cutting back the amount of LOTRO content is because I'm already producing a fairly low amount of LOTRO content in comparison with the amount of Minecraft content. So I don't want to do even less LOTRO. I think I'd rather do... a little less... These crows aren't going to attack me, are they? No. Okay. I'd rather do less Minecraft and keep the same amount of LOTRO simply because I am already producing so much Minecraft content. So, let's see. Let's go gather some of this wheat. And I think this episode might be a little bit longer than a normal one. Normally, I go about 15 minutes per episode and then do some stuff off camera and then record for another 15 minutes. But I think I might let this one go just a little bit longer. Maybe I'll let this one go to, I don't know, 20 minutes or so. Maybe 25. We'll see. There's a trowel over here. I just want to get some of these quests completed. Just kind of do a mix of different quests, because there's several different quest givers in this little North Cotton Farms area, and I want to at least do a quest from each one of them. We've already hit most of them. There's some more wheat over here. All in all, you basically have to make pies, do pipeweed, clear the fields for Nibs Chubb, which we've completely done. We completed all of Nibs Chubb's quests. And then basically make the area prettier, get rid of the rats and the random tools lying around and things like that. So it's not super bad. Basically comes down to area beautification. And we'll talk to her. Defeat rats at the windmill. I'm not entirely sure where the windmill is. I think it was down that way. We'll head over there eventually. I see another quest giver right over here. This is the pipeweed one. This one's super fast and easy. Might I have a word with you? Because it basically is just go harvest the pipeweed. And the pipeweed is all over here, if I remember correctly. And then once you harvest it, you just bring it over here, put it in barrels. Maybe the pipeweed's not over there. Where is the pipeweed? Thought it was around here somewhere. Maybe not. Maybe I'm losing my mind. I thought I said get on my horse. There we go. So let's head... Let's see if we can find this pipeweed. I know it's got to be around here somewhere. Pipeweed hoe. Oh, there's another hoe. Gotta collect my hoes. There we go. 3 of my 4 hoes. These are rats. We needed to kill rats. I remember. Let's kill some rats. Let's go for the biggest, toughest rat that we can find, and maybe all the other ones then will just run. No? No, they're not just gonna run? Okay. Well, it was worth a shot. We'll just get rid of some of these. And for the last one, I'm going to go into overkill mode and just bear it. Okay. Oh, I just... You know what? I hadn't even thought about it, but I'm a bear, and that opens up so many opportunities for just terrible puns that I have not been taking advantage of this entire series. I'm a little ashamed of myself to say that. Oh well. Not really sure where I'm supposed to be going from here. Oh, pipeweed. There it is. I knew it was around here somewhere. And then we have to kill crows as well. So we'll get some of this. And we'll kill some crows. And get some more pipeweed. And kill some more crows. It's a vicious cycle, guys. A vicious cycle. Alright. Half the crows that we need are slain. Or driven away. And only need one more crow now. We also need three more pipeweed. And we'll get this one. And this one as well. Alright, and then last but not least, one more crow. Problem solved. So that's all good. Now the pipeweed lady is up this way, I think. Pretty sure. Pretty sure pipeweed lady is like right over here. Indeed. Hello, pipeweed lady. Could I take a moment of your time? And then you just have to sort it, which is super easy. Basically, click the three barrels. That quest is done. This is like the fastest little quest line of the whole bunch. And then you need to bring it to the drying racks, which are right over here. This one's fast and easy because they're all congregated in a nice small little area, which is quite nice. Makes things go considerably faster. And then you get to head back and talk to her again. Oh, get on your horse. But I think you guys kind of get the idea here. And guys, I think I do need to go ahead and wrap up this video right here because we're getting a little long. So guys, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. I really do appreciate it, and it really, really helps out my channel. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. There are links in the video description below, so check that out as well. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll definitely see you next time.